So you put in a proposal, they didn't want to design, they wanted a serious about this process. They kept asking the board see some. So then we made, so this is a, it was, unfortunately, it needs to be big, this thing. We made this drawing of seven parts, very long drawing of seven parts, and it was a kind of, again, the whole, it was a history of education, it's also everything that we think a school should be and should contain and blah, blah, blah. It's based on a photo that Mel Gibbon had
already. The point with you, you say, it doesn't matter, right? You wrote this poem, which I had, this nuclear power station, which we were decommissioning in Wales, so trying to decommission. Near what this poem called a hole, a tractor, a nuclear reactor. That's why I have a poetry, so we have to put it in here. You following me?
Yeah, this is important. So then we made Bruce had this exhibition in Talbot Rice Gallery. He invited us to do this, to give a kind of a mini retrospective.
A survey, sure.
And the interesting thing is that the gallery is part of the university, so it's kind of very much, it's although it's a gallery that has shows for the artists, but it's also this idea that's within this kind of educational context. So we thought, well, this would be an excellent place to show a model for what a new school should be like. Not a model like this thing, but kind of something bigger that you could sort of be in some way, its own environment. So we started off with my dad's theory, which obviously both of us hadn't understood the school, so we brought to reacquaint ourselves with it. And we built this thing called the Pythagorean School, which of course doesn't work in three dimensions.
No, I still can't understand this.
So it doesn't scale.
It doesn't scale up. If there's just some cubic thing, I can't get it. Is there a maths teacher here?
I'm okay. Yeah. Anyway, we weren't designing the school, but they said, all right, we can. that's
a take. So, I just go back to my thing, was it was listed as potentially wilderness. A lot of primary schools, they wouldn't let the children go out into the wilderness because of all various problems. So, we worked out how to do it. So, we had just cameras on a duck pond, cameras up a tree, cameras down a hall, and then all the information came back into a room where they just sit and put the tape or video and all the stuff. So it wasn't going to go out, they weren't out, if you know what I mean. That didn't go out.
So we're losing
the tools. Is it any choice for how the thing might be? The thing is if I make a lot of drawings, I'm not thinking about what it is that's doing this, and usually probably drop out, so I know, because I don't know what I'm doing. But in fact, you look at things a little later on, you can pick things up, and it helps to be a little bit free sometimes.
And so one of the key aspects of this project was the idea that maybe we could make this wall and it could be something like some notion of measurement, and you could actually think about the school as measuring the school. That was the idea of this building kind of facade or whatever. But of course it's made in England, and maybe Scotland had to change it anyway.
Yeah. Well, everything we do ability to be answerable by the staff. If it was made of this one, it was that size one, if they asked the question, they didn't want to ask the question, but if they did ask the question, we would really answer. We built it to quite severe specifications, but it got shifted by the architects and dodgy goings on the golf course.
Anyway, there was also a book about service there's these idea of houses became very important. Yeah. There's a sound house, an opera house, or whatever house, and so that you make these environments for certain activities. It doesn't mean that another activity can't go on in a, you know, you can play a banjo in a
science room.
Yeah, exactly, you know, whatever. So it's all interchangeable, but then why not have a rather than making these general environments weren't very good for anything in a way.
So I mean, one of the rooms we had was a kitchen, which was a room. Yeah. And he went into the kitchen to add the scones, those things are baking, you could cook things like that.
Well, every surface thing.
All these coffee things. You can make stuff. Well, yeah, anyway, it's all sort of fantastic. Garden of vegetables that would grow and learning trenches and full of tunnels. This is a section through the school.
And so the yeah.
This was a what they wanted was a room, a quiet room for reading in and a library. And so we wanted to dig a hole in here, which we didn't have to. So you sit down here, and this was a quiet room. There's also a corner. You sit in this corner, and all that was going to be for reading. And this year, two sections, one for the children, and one for the sports bit in the evening, which all the people come back and have a separate bit. So this wall can separate.
Yeah, I think you mentioned earlier. So this thing that runs along the length of the school. Right. One side is public, one is the school, so the school is kind of protected in that sense. And all these, the idea for this wall was that it was going to be drawn all over again, based on using all the drawings that we worked together with the.
That is embedding that into the school, so that's what it's come from, and there it is, you know.
But they did that, went to planning, and they said, we can't have a school that's got, a new school that's got graffiti all over it.
And so that was just new. Brilliant, Sylvia from Chicago, for economical reasons, you shouldn't have much off the end of it. It doesn't make any sense. imagine an Olympic size, whatever, what you call it, a gym hall. So we made this gold, this is gold, going for gold, gold metal. This is gold metal. And we worked out the weight that would be.
I think it says it,
the weight of that was a solid lump of gold. So that's written on the side. So you know that if a child said, we've got a school that's got a lump of gold that's 8 million billion tons. Bigger than yours, mate. It's good stuff, it's all stuff. It's like we come to the meals, you go to somewhere, you also remember the horse's head coming out of the headmaster's office or something. Something may happen or anything. You also remember that. It's one of the things we need to remember. And people can make stories about the lie about it. People don't lie about anything because I'm inventing it. It's all streamlined. It's all boxed down to go. It's all good.
Yeah, it's a bit of a good thing. Well, this isn't private finance in this one, of course. So they paid what the dreadful builders Stephen had right to do at this. And at least it's paid off, I suppose. But again, as part of us being involved in this thing, just being kind of advocates for the school in some way, we managed to go. We honestly really happy we did it for them, but we managed, I think it helped that this is a huge gym hall. Yeah. It's actually a really fantastic kind of facility. Just used by the local, all sorts of sports groups. So that, all that stuff is good. So
we did something, but this is a, here you can see the spaceship, which is a brain. And this is where you come in to the school here, and these are drawings that the archivist, do you see archivist? An actress, archivist, art lady, she got her students to draw an image of the school. And then we put them behind these French measures, that's the school as they see it. So that's fantastic. Really good drawings. And all I'd like to do now is take these drawings and go to the school and look like that. Right. I mean, and they're all up for it.
Well, whatever, you have to smash it
up. There's another one, there's another all the other versions are out there, so yeah, I saw that.
Now, well, I don't know whether you should get onto it, but I mean, the trouble is, right, if you do that, you think, that's not uninteresting, maybe, or whatever, maybe it's not interesting, I'm interested in lots of products. But so you do this, and it's beautiful, finished, a nice house, and then this is what I want to put this on, and then this. It's laminated. It has this little blue sort of borders around it. I don't like the type. I mean, the idea of art is not something that's promoted in this country, and it's actually kind of it's denigrated through education somewhere else. So the minute you do this, it's sort of totally not destroyed, but stuff is stuck all over. So you can't ever see it. No, it's not that it's precious. I think with the monkeys. And I don't think it should be putting barriers around paintings. I mean, I understand you're protective, but I think if it gets worn and things get rubber, I think wear and tear is absolutely fine. Or if you think it's a load of old rubbish and get to it, then chuck it out the window and then you can campaign to get it or whatever. But the idea of just gradually just destroying something through a kind of actively attacking it, neglecting it, or because of, I don't know. And there was a bit of storage, and actually we went
see a portrait of the Pet Vicious standing in the middle of the room, he photographed with her a yellow light on and a blue light on and the other three colors in the black, which you get to make up color. There's a photograph in the room of her. It explains how color printing is done, if you want to do that. You don't, they might be saying it's my great view, but that doesn't make a very simple.
Yes.
That's a Jim Hall convention.
This is for the. This is a. There's an idea as well of having, including other things in the school that were kind of instruments or kind of tools or other ways of looking at the world. So this is a prism, an acrylic prism that went at the height of one of the classrooms, which you lived through. Or then we can direct the sun through and create a spectrum in the classroom on one of the walls.
Is that another issue?
No, no, we were worried about set the school before. But and then there were things like this on the window, which was this idea of the relationship of scale between objects. And this piece, this thing here, was an inch down to kind of circle. And then we never built the other object. The other, we're going to build this 9-foot globe and a playing field.
Yeah.
Which then you look at this idea of a scale relationship between
objects. The other idea was that we won't be actually completing the final drawing school. It was drawn on a golden section. And the golden section started in one space. There's a plate, I think the plate's not there yet, but there's going to be a plate in the school that goes there and goes out as it does as far. Like you look at the landscape, I'm going to put markers in that landscape and put in the local area, maybe it's gone away, one would be in the Glasgow. See, if you actually know that aspect of our school, if you're still connected to the school, it's still connected to the world. I wish we'd done that, but I didn't do that. We're out of money. That's the thorny tree, it was flagged in the generator. The light in the sanction.
The 30-watt bulb.
20-watt bulb, 50-watt.
And then this is the allowance for the graffiti inside the school, where the graffiti is in for the but that was a shame that that wasn't And there's
the
that's
all right.
Yeah, that's all right. It's not outside the school. That's
that's five pages. On the Slate School of Fine Art, we did a couple of workshops up there. Well, they planted potatoes 1 year, and then they dug them up the next year, and they had this huge meal with a cooked over the show with the potatoes people. And that was very good. I was done with this guy, Eddie Farrell. And he's involved in some teaching and stuff. She's involved in dream. There he is in Iceland. They're all doing funny things involved with teaching things. And what happened was that I was teaching them at the time, but they got involved with Will and many other people, and they all did this. They did a week's workshop, which is absolutely extraordinary workshop. The whole school was there. And I think they should get rid of the teachers and put them in instead, because it's much better for other schools to come on. It's amazing how light things, projections.
But you have
that. I wasn't going to go to the hospital. That's all right. You can't say it does. Who said that? That's a huge bushel. There's 450 children. Not one stayed away, not one fainted, not one was crying, but they're all laughing. Okay. This wasn't meant to be, it was to do with you.
I think this is it.
But the thing
that's what Tolkien was saying there is
what interests me about doing anything is that it's not what you do that's interesting, it's the incidental things that you get out of the thing. It's what occurred to me after you before, not after, more or less when it's finished. I thought, you know, what we've actually done is not build a school, which is not what we wanted, but what it is, it's another venue for looking at and disseminating visual arts. The arts are in the school. It's not, oh, this is a piece of art, let's go and look at it. This is a school, and there's a castle on the wall, or sort of that kind of thing. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. They take it or leave it. And I come from Glasgow, where I used to go with my parents to khakis in restaurants, and tea rooms around in Glasgow. And I turned up in the 50s. There were Renoirs and Van Goghs and Cezannes on the walls of tea students. Because this rich student is rotten. And then you can sit and have a cup of tea and look at this painting and all this stuff that a friend can think. And that's a way to go, it's a way to acquire information and knowledge without being restricted by that. You know, so say, look at that, understand that that's a society full of modern bullshit, you know, painting. And I think that the school is a fantastic venue.
But there was a discussion about having a travelling exhibition that was stopped. I mean, it was the lunch hall in the schools is enormous.
Yeah.
It's a big wall, and that was, there was an idea that you can have these kind of touring exhibitions.
It's a huge wall. I'm not sure I'll get a big chest to Douglas Gordon, the American staff, to do anything.
But it could maybe happen, but I mean, it could happen. So that was the idea that you build in this kind of.
Yeah, well, you've got to get somebody in the education authority who's going to do that. I'm not going to do it. I'm just going to have time to make sculpture.
Yeah.
Do something like a book. But I think if I was going to do it again, I'd work with artists and engage the artists and the students and give everyone a chance to do something. But also coming from this, I just see why that occurred to the group, actually, which is an idea. We were going into Dalry or Irvine with a place that takes the pressure. And there's a great big shed, and outside of the shed there's great big propellers and huge turbines of ships. I mean, he said, why is it a museum? Just put a glass box over here, and there's a school, and it's an urban academy, and it's based on a propeller. And the history of that whole area is in the thing, and they've got all these museums that are never connected to schools. All these bloody people go to the Holland and Museum. Every village has got to mix lace or make cheap coffee or make something. You can build a museum to this. Go to school, all the museums, and everyone who goes to that place learns about the history of where they're coming from. I think it's quite important. I was going to say something else, but I won't say that. You know what Gap is, don't you? Geriatrics at play. Well, not any university. But I think that I was speaking to somebody in Scotland after the school was built. He said, well, I find an idea. He said, I think we should bring back national service. And I went, ooh. I said, no, not national service in the military. But everybody, he thinks that everybody in Britain should do 1 year in a foundation course in an art school. When they leave school to understand how to draw, how to look at things, how to imagine to draw things, and how to understand a lot of things, because we're all involved with the design, involved with all these things, but people are, you know, don't understand a lot of things. And drawing is, as some people pointed out earlier, are fundamental to everything. Everyone understands that you can learn when you talk, you can learn when you write, but you can't learn when you draw. And it's quite important. Universal international language of drawing. And if everyone starts to draw, I think it would be a better situation. Everyone has to do it, whether it's university, study medicine, or whatever, but good for you. Do you want
to
say anything else?
Well,
I'm going to go
right on now. I love you, thank you.
Much better. Performance art,
it's not performance art, it's live
action sculpture.
Okay, it's live action sculpture. Okay.
Ask something else.
I'm not sure I really enjoy it, but I'm not sure I understood what was going on. But actually, in the context of what you brought together here at Dalry,
to look at a performance. Going to the theatre is a performance, and it's not a performance for you to get dressed up and say, the restaurant is a performance. People don't get that. Some people get it, the restaurant hotels get it, and they get a performance. I don't want to spend 100,000 and have a bum tie. I want to be part of a performance. Do you?
Well,
what time is it?
I'll get some questions, Michelle.
Or something, say, no, that's the idea, you can do that.
No, I don't think that.
done that you have never seen in the 50s. Big things which have been removed. Really? I mean, and then, oh, right, now it's because of
there's something that's wrong with that history.
Yeah, I know, but it happens. I mean, I think you can't stop it. I think you shouldn't. I mean, I might argue that there's a drawing of the local thing on the wall coming down. It's there for the next generation to deal with. If you add to it or respond to it, but just to wipe it out is a bit.
I'm with you.
No, I can't be disappointed. I'd rather be dead than disappointed. Things that have happened up to me.
Do you think it's me?
On the board, I've got some kind of board, which is now not wrong.
Yeah.
When I come, you say nothing about the loss of our public cars. I think we can.
I'm not saying you shouldn't stop it, but I think it seems to be the way things are.
I think the commission process ought to be that if work is commissioned by public money, then that public ethos stays with the work.
Yeah.
It's not the right.
It's not the right
to an engineer or manager of a building to say no more. They have the right of execution. We, the public, respond to this thing. We, the public, control it. And that will be the future.
No, I don't agree with that. But unfortunately, you quite sure the photographs when I went back to the school, what I saw, I couldn't photograph. I tried to say it was a health hazard, but I actually tried to set that light.
So I'm not like this comes to sites where the work goes. You know, I'm used to that. But it's the explanations for the aguous at times, just sheer incompetence, neglect, ignorance.
I think sometimes it's not just benign and neglect. It's actually
Sometimes it's actually malicious.
Yes,
petrol or the drink, I don't know.
She was brigading the public barber. Well, he's got these lunatics up front, and how much will they